A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13 December, on the front page you have anti-cab protests raged through Assam, two killed in police firing. So these are mob attacks on houses of MLAs and ministers in Assam, offices of BJP AGP, Assam Gana Parishad, have been vandalized. So these are protests against CAB, that is Citizenship Amendment Bill. So Citizenship Amendment Bill has seen maximum protests in northeastern states because these are the states where migrants stay over, and the government through the Citizenship Amendment Bill is facilitating acquisition of citizenship for these migrants from neighboring countries like Bangladesh. And what is happening is that here the non-Muslim immigrants are going to easily get citizenship. So that is going to affect majorly the northeastern states. The government has exempted northeastern states from the provisions of Citizenship Amendment Bill. So it is exempted, means all seven northeastern states except few regions of Assam and Tripura are exempted, either through inner line permit system or through the special status which they have under 6th schedule of the constitution. But there are violent protests here taking place in Assam. Then here you have IIP shrinks again, inflation accelerates. So index of industrial production has shrunk again, you can see. Food inflation is at 18 month high, and index of industrial production for the month of October 2019 is at 3.8%. So it has contracted for the third consecutive month. Here is the data given. So this is below zero, that is negative. It is contracted, it's not expansion. So contracted by 3.8% means it's minus 3.8% growth. It's not growing, it's contracting in that sense. And CPI is increasing. And specifically, food inflation is at 40 month high. Then below you have Supreme Court forms panel to probe Hyderabad encounter. So Supreme Court has set up an inquiry commission led by former judge Justice V.S. Sirpurkar. So he is going to investigate into the circumstances of the police encounter killing four persons accused in the gang rape and murder of veterinarian in Hyderabad. So this alleged encounter will be investigated into. On page 9 you have CAG hints at massive diversion of LPG. So this is Comptroller and Auditor General of India. In its report, it has found that around 13.96 lakh beneficiaries of Pradhan Mantri Ujwala Yojana scheme consumed 3 to 41 refills in a month. So this has highlighted the risk of diversion of domestic LPG cylinders for commercial use. So 1.98 lakh beneficiaries had an average annual consumption of more than 12 cylinders. So this level of consumption seemed improbable in view of the BPL status of such beneficiaries. This is a detail given here. And this is Lotus on passport is security feature. So Ministry of External Affairs says national symbols will be used. And the opposition members raised the issue of Lotus being printed on new passports. So government says it's part of enhanced security feature to identify fake passports. So Lotus is also the symbol of BJP, political party. Then this is IBM's weather forecast system to tap users' phones for data. So this is international technology company IBM, which plans to make a higher resolution weather forecast model that will also rely on user generated data to improve the accuracy of forecasts available in India. So it's called IBM Graph. So it's a forecast system which can generate forecasts at a resolution of 3 kilometers. So it's a significantly higher resolution than 12 kilometer models used by Indian Meteorological Department to generate forecasts. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is an exoneration. So this is regarding the yesterday's front page news that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been given a clean chit in the Gujarat riot case of 2002 by G.T. Nanavati A.H. Mehta Commission. So this editorial says that a clean chit to Prime Minister Modi is unsurprising, but riots can't be described as spontaneous. And the second editorial, Nation #194. So this is regarding nation number 194, that is Bougainville. So it is some distance from nationhood, but its people have spoken. So they have clearly stated what they want. So this is regarding that. and it will be formed from Papua New Guinea. So the country will be getting independence from Papua New Guinea. So it is rich in mineral resources, you can see, and it has been fighting for independence for long. This is a non-binding referendum to ascertain preference for either greater autonomy or separate statehood, which was conducted and which saw overwhelming majority voting for independence. So this is the detail. And the lead article is in the name of a majority. So this is regarding National Register of Citizens in Assam. So NRC exercise has been conducted in Assam, and it has been fraught with risks as such, and many exclusions, and many tribals have also been excluded because they don't have the documents to prove that they have been residing for long in Assam. The cutoff date was of 1985. So this has given us an indication of risks involved in NRC like exercise of inclusion and exclusion. Still the government go ahead with plans for NRC and a citizenship amendment bill. So that raises concerns. And this is not many lessons learned from water planning failure. So it says in the absence of scientific planning and implementation, measures like Jal Shakti Abhiyan may not be successful. So planning scientifically as such is important for water planning as such. Judicious use of water. And the aim and intent of Jal Shakti Abhiyan is noble, but the assumptions it says are distorted. It assumes that common people in rural areas are ignorant and prone to wasting water. On the contrary, they are the ones who first bear the brunt of any water crisis. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, you have parle coverage. That is, an issue is raised and news counter views are given. So this is regarding, should the creamy layer norm be extended to SCSTs? So we have creamy layer in OBC, should it be there for SCSTs too? So it says reservation for Dalits is not to undo economic backwardness, but to remedy for untouchability. So their reservation is just not just for economic purpose, but years of persecution and years of undermining their rights is to be compensated for. So that's the idea of reservation. So that's why it is said there should not be any economic criteria in SCSTs. No creamy layer concept. But then there are counter views too. Because if you don't have creamy layer, then the downtrodden within SCST would never get benefits of reservation. The creamy layer would take away all the benefits because they are more aware. They reach out for the opportunities and the reservation provisions which are available. Then on page 12 you have Supreme Court dismisses 19 Ayodhya review pleas. So, 5-judge bench of the Supreme Court led by Chief Justice of India Sharad Bobde on Thursday dismissed 19 petitions seeking review of Supreme Court's judgment on November 9 regarding the construction of a temple on the land in Ayodhya where Babri Masjid stood before it was razed on December 6, 1992 by car savers. So, one petition said the verdict had a direct impact on the secular fabric of India. So, these review pleas have been dismissed. Means Supreme Court will not hear these review pleas. And below you have Article 370 petitioners seek a larger bench. So the petitioners challenging abrogation of special status of Jammu and Kashmir under Article 370 have sought a larger bench because they say past two judgments, both by 5-judge benches of the Supreme Court, gave contradictory viewpoints on Article 370. In 1959, Premnath Kaul versus State of Jammu and Kashmir indicates that Article 370 was applicable only till Jammu and Kashmir Constitution was enacted on 26 Jan 1957. After that, no further changes could be made to the relationship between India and Jammu and Kashmir. And another judgment is of 1970, Sampath Prakash versus State of Jammu and Kashmir. In this, the 1959 verdict was ignored and it concluded that Article 370 was permanent in nature and a perennial source of power for the centre to govern its relation with the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So the petitioners now demand a larger bench because of this conflict of opinion in the two verdicts. Then on international page you have Trump signs order targeting anti-Semitism at universities. So Semitism actually is related to Jewish religion. So anti-Semitism is anti-Jewish tendencies. So he has signed an order, the president has signed an order targeting any such moves in universities. So colleges that allow such activities will be denied funds. And this is fire on Russia's only aircraft carrier kills one. So Russia's only aircraft carrier, you can see, suffered a massive fire that killed one crew member and injured 11 people and significantly damaged the ship. So this is Admiral Kuznetsov, which is the only aircraft carrier of Russia. On business page you have IOC OIL in race for Bharat Petroleum's Umligarh unit. So we know BPCL, Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, government is planning to sell off its stake here. But then for the Umligarh refinery, the government is going to have a separate sale. So here public sector oil companies, Indian Oil Corporation Limited and Oil India Limited, are in the race to buy BPCL's 61.65% stake in Umligarh Refinery Limited in Assam. So this is regarding that. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.